Previously on The Walking Dead.
Thank you.
Let's get back to it.
And we're back. Hello, everybody. My name is Lee, and I am Le Badass. Look at it. Well, looks like these people were dicks.
Must be the guy who ran this place. Looks like he figured himself as some kind of supreme leader.
Most likely. That's an X. I don't want to go there. Ooh, a locker. It's bloody. Touch it. It's weird that that's my first instinct when it says bloody locker. I don't... See, in my mind, I'm thinking about stuff in the locker, not like the blood part. Goth, but not that goth. Blood scares me. Hello.
You guys need any help?
Thanks, but I think we're almost in.
I totally forgot about that guy's existence. Okay. Well, I guess I'm gonna go exploring. Come on, Lee. I'm going on an adventure. It's gonna be great. Okay. We are together again. I don't know why the recording thing isn't showing me the time anymore. Sorry, it's computer stuff that I am failing at. It usually shows me how much time has gone by in the little corner.
Little help!
Oh, okay. I was explaining shit, damn it. Oh, Q. Q. E. Oh, no. I didn't aim hard enough. Catch it. That'll do it. Q. Q like a son of a bitch. E. I hate rapid pressing. That sounds really weird the way I said it.
Damn well better.
But I really don't like it.
We got the fuel.
Let's not start high-fiving each other just yet. Let's get the hell back to the classroom.
Yeah.
Let's handle these fuel cans. They weigh a goddamn ton.
With stuff on the recording. Sly in the cutscene.
Yeah, we made out pretty good too.
Great work, yes, it's Kenny. Showing it now. Thank you.
How you doing with that door?
That was gonna bother me.
Not so good. Here.
Damn it, Ben.
Give you a hand.
Ben, you bumbling
buffoon.
Did you get
that battery yet?
Yeah. Molly has it. She should be back here soon.
She'd better be.
I tell myself that every time I talk to a guy. He'll be back. Let's not talk about my love life. Hi, Bree.
Bree?
Hey, Lee. Thanks for all your help back there.
You're so welcome.
I don't think we would have made it without you.
No problem. We're all on the same team.
Oh, yeah. We play sports. You're a cancer survivor.
So you're a cancer survivor, like Vernon and the others.
Yeah, I was diagnosed when I was in college.
Damn.
Been getting treatment ever since. Just when I was starting to get better, thought there might be some hope. All this happened. Lost my whole family. I'm the only one who survived. Funny how things work out, huh?
Good lord. Vernon. He seems nice.
How long have you known Vernon?
Couple of years. He ran our support group. He was really great, helping me come to terms with my disease. But how do you come to terms with something like this? With a place like Crawford? I don't know what I or the other survivors would have done without Vernon. He's the one who held us together, kept us alive.
You acquire weed and you smoke it. That way you could giggle about it all. Crawford.
What do you think about this whole Crawford situation?
I'd rather not talk about it. Too many awful memories. Even being back here gives me a bad feeling.
Even now, with everyone dead?
I got no sympathy for what happened to these people. They weeded out the sick and the old, even children, those least able to defend themselves so that they could save their own skins. Whatever happened here, however Crawford fell, I consider it poetic justice.
Damn, girl, that's cold.
It's how I feel. If you'd seen what I seen, you'd feel the same.
Lee's commentary. Damn, that's cold.
Lee, maybe you should go get that battery or help with the medicine.
Fine. Okay. Let's see. Rug.
Hopscotch.
Okay. you're not a real conversationalist, are you? Pamphlets? I hate that word.
Looks like they have quite a system here. Crawford's final solution.
Ooh. That sounds very... very Hitler. I don't like it. Why? Okay, I had to, like, press something to back out. I didn't realize. Okay, talk to you. I love you.
You okay, Clem?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
This desk is just like the ones we have in my school.
Aw.
I know it's weird, but I kinda miss it, being in school.
Of course. It's normal. I miss teaching.
Me too. I used to be a teacher, remember? Tell you what, when we find ourselves a safe place, set up a little classroom. Just you and me.
I love it.
Will there be homework?
No homework.
Where's Molly?
She had to go run an errand. She'll be back soon.
I hope she's okay.
Me too.
She'll be fine. She's pretty tough.
I hope she doesn't skip town.
Do you think things will ever be normal again? Just like the way they were before?
Remember what Kat said.
I don't know, sweet pea. But we all have to believe they will. Remember what Kat just said back on the farm?
Yeah.
She said
I was hoping he'd reference that.
And now she's dead.
But we're not. We're still alive. And we have to keep hope alive, too. It's the one thing none of this can take away.
Yeah. As long as we have belief and don't let this get to us, we can remain strong. Because what I've seen a lot is people dying from lack of mental fortitude. Like, either they lose it and kill someone else, or they lose it and get themselves killed, or they lose it and kill themselves. And that, I don't know if I already said that, but yeah, belief. I like the little spin he did.
What do we still need?
We already got the fuel and the battery. Once we find some medicine, we'll be good to go.
Well, where the
hell? So where's this battery you found?
With Molly.
She ran off to do something.
Well, she'd better bring it back here. I don't know why you trusted that girl with it. We hardly know her.
Why'd you say girl like that?
She saved your life, didn't she?
Sexist.
Yeah, but what has she done for me lately?
Jeez.
No, wait. There is something you can help me with.
Yes?
There's something that's been on my mind. I could use your opinion.
No.
What is it?
It's Kenny. Since I've been helping him work on the boat, I've gotten to know him a little better. He's a good guy, you know? And it's eating me up knowing what I know. I've been thinking about telling him the truth.
Ben, come on. This again?
It's my fault Doc and Katja got killed. If I hadn't screwed up back at the motor inn, they'd still be alive. How am I supposed to just carry something like that around? I have to tell him.
It wasn't your fault, man. Well, it was your fault, but it wasn't... Why did I do that? I didn't choose an option. I just look all pensive.
I guess you've got your own problems. Look, don't worry about it. I'll figure it out. I'm gonna get back to this.
I'm sorry, I didn't really agree with any of those options. Ben, it's honestly, I don't think it's directly your fault. I know that the actions that you did kind of led up to it, but you didn't cause it. It's more of a correlation of events rather than a causation. You thought you'd be saving your friend, and you didn't mean for that to happen. You thought that you'd be saving everyone by doing that. You didn't mean to kill Duck and Katja, and you technically didn't. But things kind of just happen, and I don't know if Kenny will see it that way. That I don't think he should tell him. I don't. But I didn't want to be like, are you fucking nuts? Because he freaking squeal and crap, and I don't like when he squeals at me. But rant over.
So according to Bree, fuel is at the maintenance shed. Medicine might be at the nurse's office. And a battery would probably be at the auto shop out through here.
Well, we only need medicine, Lee, and I could have... Nurse's office.
If we're gonna find medicine anywhere, that would be the place to look.
Thanks, Lee. I guess we're gonna go
the
there.
Georgia State flag. A lot of history there. Not that it matters much now, I guess.
Lee, as a history teacher, you know that history always matters. It helps us deal with the present. You dick. I'm gonna school you. Why? Where the hell is the nurse's station? I'm really, really lost here. Nurse, I'm wounded. I have a boo-boo. Exit to playground. I wanna go there. Ooh, shell casting. Bathroom? Water fountain? That's not gonna work, Lee. I'm not even gonna try that shit. I don't wanna do that. Alrighty, shell casings? Where were they? I wanna pick them up. Hello, friends.
Already been fired.
Well, wow. You are a pessimist, my friend. Can I go this way? Why is this just so difficult? Why am I so bad at this? Go this way. Maybe it's over here. Can I open it now? Do I have something? I don't.
Shit.
Oh my! That, and of course, that's probably a nursing station, right? Yep.
Trapped in there.
Freaking. Hide. Oh, never mind. Wow, I'm horrible shot. I wasted freaking bullets. I was doing well in the beginning, and then I kind of... I thought there were three left, and I didn't expect to... Krista, really?
They wandered into the hallway after we got inside. I think they must have heard us rooting around in here. The whole place is infested. They're everywhere.
Yeah.
Calm down. I took care of them. What about the meds? Did we find what we need?
Yeah, that's our other problem.
Oh,
take
no.
a look.
Why... Why?
Looks like they were keeping all the prescription meds in that safe, locked up tight.
Well, damn it. Can we bust it open?
There's no way we can bust it open.
Maybe with enough time, but I don't know how much of that we have. Be a hell of a lot quicker if we just knew the four-digit combination.
Well, I doubt they just wrote it down and left it here for us to find. We should just try busting it open. We don't have any other choice.
Saying bad words.
Okay, you get started.
Sorry.
I'll take a look around, see if I can find anything useful.
I meant to be like, does anyone know how to crack a safe or crack codes? Or a combination hacker or something. But, that was not the way that it came out of my mouth. And I apologize. What the heck?
What's this on the floor?
It's a sonogram.
Oh. That makes me sad. I don't want to look at... What the fuck?
There's dried blood on this printout. And on the floor. Looks like a trail of it from the safe to the camera over there. Then out the door. What the hell happened here?
I don't know, but maybe we should look at the camera? I'm not gonna shoot that safe. That's really dumb, Lee. Where are you? Clock? I don't really... Camcorder. It's the only thing I can actually touch.
No tape inside.
Well, Hey, medical file. Cool. Bingo.
Correa. Guess she must have been a patient here. And what's this?
A tape. I love tapes. Okay. We're gonna put it in the camcorder, and that will make me happy.
Vernon, Krista, come look at this.
This is day 82 since the outbreak.
Oh.
1547, Dr. Logan in consultation with patient Anna Correa.
She's so pretty.
Why are you recording this?
This is a creepy son of a bitch.
Regulations. Oberson has ordered me to keep records of all medical examinations and consultations. I need you to brace yourself, Anna. The sonogram confirms that you're pregnant.
Oh, God.
Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God.
As you know, the rules are very clear. The termination is mandatory.
You don't have to tell them. Tell them it was just nausea. That you gave me something for it and it went away. This is my problem, not yours.
If Oberson finds out that I concealed evidence of a pregnancy, I'm sorry, but these are the rules. I'm going to give you a sedative. It'll make the procedure easier on you.
Oh, my God.
I don't want that procedure. I want my baby. I can't do this. I can't do this.
Anna, you don't have a choice. Now, if you like, you can take some time with this. But I need you to come back no later than tomorrow, or I'll have no choice but to inform Oberson myself. I'm sorry.
Good God.
Damn it. We almost had it.
What the hell kind of place was this?
Like Molly said.
Hell?
The worst kind.
Lee, maybe there's another tape. We gotta keep looking.
Yeah.
I think I recognize that doctor. He was one of the walkers out in the alley
he
by the other side.
He was! Jane went to town on him.
See what he's got on him.
Wait, I have to go back and look at... I don't want to. I have to go back into the alley and look at that guy? Ugh. Why does this game hate me? It's making me go around the world and shit. Okay, fine. Okay. I'll be back, guys. Don't wait up. Okie doke. Sorry, I had a little sniffle. I always get allergies when it's about to rain. It's the weirdest thing. My mom has it and I have it. Where every time it's about to rain or it is raining, our allergies act up like crazy. I don't usually have allergies anyway, but I mean, they get bad in winter because there's a lot of moisture in the air, but I was ranting and I forgot what I was doing. You'd think that made me stop talking, but nope. I'll keep ranting because I'm an ass. Okie dokie, where's that walker that Jane mutilated like crazy? I guess here. Yeah, because I remember that sign. Why am I talking to myself? It's also very late at my house, so I don't want anyone in my family to think I'm crazy by talking to a camera. Oh, wow. Okay. Least of my concerns now. I have a walker. Dick. Oh, goodness. You don't have an arm. What? Where? My question... Where? Whatever, man. Thanks for... being an old TV, I guess. Oh my, you're still alive? How the hell? That is really unlikely. She like... Okay, never mind. Stomp you. You're a dick, mister. Sorry, sir. I'm gonna search you. Looting. A tape.
Why? This might be just what we need. What's this? Looks like some kind of code. But Vernon said the safe combination was only 4 numbers.
Oh. Oh my.
Shit.
He should have seen me, honestly. Looked. Oh no. I thought it was just gonna transport me back to the nurse's station, but I mean, the game isn't that much of a sweetheart. I can make your hands clap. I can make the door closed.
I found another tape. The this was there, dated finished October it.
10th. That's the day after the first one we watched.
Put it in.
That's what she said. Oh, I need to stop. Can you tell I haven't
have
got
you
sleep?
Made a decision?
I thought you said I didn't have a choice.
Well, technically you do. You can terminate the pregnancy or leave Crawford. Of course, that would be a death sentence for both you and your unborn child.
Maybe that's best. I stayed up all last night thinking about this. Why are we even trying to survive? To keep on living? If this is what it takes. If this is what it's turned us into.
I don't make the rules, Anna.
Doctor, I'm begging you. Please help me.
Maybe one day, when things are different, you can try again. But for now, today, we have to do this.
No. You say she has a choice, but you're making her. Oh my.
No. No. No.
Oh my. Well, she killed the man.
I think we know what happened to Crawford.
Yeah. More importantly, we got the combination.
Krista? What's up with her? What's wrong? Why did I click out?
Krista, are you all right? What's wrong?
It's nothing. That was just hard to watch. Don't worry about me. I'm fine.
All right. Let's get those meds and get the hell out of here.
We're in business.
Ooh.
Antibiotics, morphine. We'll take as much of this as we can carry.
Thank goodness.
Okay, I think we're good. This is more than enough for your people and mine. Let's go.
You go on ahead. I want to make sure we didn't miss anything.
Yeah.
I'll be right behind you.
If he's saying that,
don't
I definitely
take too
missed
long.
Something. But we can't lose Omid. He's the comic relief in place of Glenn from episode one. If you remember, he was Butte. Hi. Camera? Okie dokie. Let me look at this.
Vernon and Krista already took it.
Well, you know what? You're a dick. You little bitch. Sonogram. Desk. Doors?
Nothing in here, I guess.
Okay, fine. Where are you? First aid?
Well, you know.
Okay. Bed? No, is this where people fornicated? Kind of don't want to think about that, though. Tapes. Wait, what? There are more? Which ones?
This is day 82 since the outbreak. 1547. Dr. Logan in consultation with patient Anna Correa.
Why are you recording this?
Oh. I already saw this.
Regulations. Overson has ordered me to keep records of
all medical examinations. I don't want to watch it again.
And consultations. I need you to brace your...
I can't.
Brace yourself, Anna.
Damn it.
Sonogram confirms that you're pregnant.
I don't want to watch it again.
Oh God.
Let me leave.
As you know, the rules are very clear. The termination is mandatory.
I don't...
You don't have to tell them.
I already saw this.
Tell them it was just nausea. But you gave me something for it and it went away. This is my problem, not yours.
If Overson finds out that I concealed evidence of a pregnancy, I'm sorry, but these are the rules. I'm going to give you a sedative. It'll make the procedure easier on you.
I don't want the procedure. I want my baby.
I can't do this.
Anna, you don't have a choice. Now, if you like, you can take some time with this, but I need you to come back no later than tomorrow, or I'll have no choice but to inform Overson myself. I'm sorry.
Well, that was a waste of time. Ugh, okay, let me find something else besides the tapes I already freaking watched. Okay. Mouse, come on. Work with me here. I know you're not on a desk right now, but, Copier? Can we copy?
What is this?
I'm sorry for the notification sounds again.
Not that it matters with no
Shut up, notifications. Oh my freaking god. I'm gonna flip shit. Papers. Oh,
just
my
a bunch of papers. No safe combination, though.
Well, you know what? We already have the safe combination, Lee, so... There is one more...
No tape inside.
What? Find a check, I guess. Clock?
Not working.
Well, could have told you that, Lee. Are there more things to do with tapes or something? It's just the ones we already watched. Okay, well, I guess we're done in that room. Shut up. Everyone in this freaking group chat is, like, blowing up my computer. I really want to open it.
This must have been his locker.
Wait, what? Why is it open now? It wasn't before.
A videotape?
Yes, another one! The saga continues. Watch it. Go back. Forward. Do it. Go. I didn't think there was more since she kind of like stabbed him in the last one. Or is this, like, another one that happened in between? I don't know. We'll find out. Tape. I remember when we used tapes instead of storage cards. Oh, okay. What?
Listen, as fun as this was, I have to put a stop to this little arrangement. This is the last I can give you.
Holy crap.
Overson had someone down here yesterday taking inventory. He's really cracking down. I just can't risk it.
We had a deal.
Yes, we had a deal. We don't anymore.
My sister needs this medicine. Without it, she'll die, or she'll start showing symptoms and they'll take her away. I can't let that happen.
I'm sorry, Molly. I've done all I can, but I have to look out for myself here.
Yeah, that's the Crawford way, isn't it?
Wow.
Well, shit.
Yeah, I'll say. Damn. That's why Molly knows a lot about this. Damn. So Anna, Molly, your sisters, and Molly was fornicating with the doctor, who's creepy as fuck, to help her sister. And that's why she went all apeshit on the doctor and the... Molly, you got a bit of stuff to sort out amongst yourself. And I will help you in any way I can to heal from this experience.
Jesus,
oh, hi!
Christ.
Speaking of the devil.
Where the fuck have you been?
Sightseeing.
I'll take that battery now.
Oh, yeah. About that.
Molly.
I'm just kidding.
I can't be mad at you. I do that a lot.
Here you go.
Thank you. It's usually when my mom asks me about grades. It's like I have something to tell you.
She's What's like, that?
Nothing.
I know you're from Crawford.
You can quit with the act, Molly. I know you're from Crawford.
What? Who told you that?
I saw you on a security tape. Why'd you lie to me?
I said there were stories about Crawford. I never said that's how I knew about it. I never lied to you, and even if I did, so what? I don't owe you anything.
You saved my life twice, but you can't tell me the truth?
Are we really gonna do this now?
I guess not.
I guess that's up to you.
I used to live here with my sister. She was 14 years old. When the dead started walking and Crawford shut itself in, it seemed like a pretty good deal at first. We were safe. We had everything we needed to survive. Then the rules started coming down. No one who couldn't justify their place or their keep. No one who required special care. My sister was diabetic, and by Crawford's rules, that made her a liability. I kept it a secret. kept her safe for as long as I could. But in the end, I couldn't protect her. That's when I got out. Crawford, they always talked about how their system worked, how anything was better than becoming one of them. But I saw what they'd already become. I just wish I could have seen it before it was too late. Before they came and took my sister away. This is all I have left of her.
Oh, so it wasn't
I didn't have time to take it before I got out of Crawford. Mm. I just wanted it, okay?
It's okay, Mother. I understand. She's pretty.
What the hell?
I thought the sister was the one who was pregnant. I'm really confused. I guess I'll leave it up to you guys. If you guys know what the whole story is, let me know in the comments, because I'm confused as hell.
Oh, Jesus!
Goodness.
Sorry. I just got spooked by those bells, and then I heard someone
What are you doing?
What the fuck are you doing out here?
Kenny and I still can't get the door open to the armory. He sent me out to look for something we can use to bust it open. I found this.
Oh, no.
Ben? Where did you get that?
I know where you
got it. I just found it. It was stuck in the door handle at the end of the hallway back there.
You freaking idiot. How did you not notice that there were walkers there, you dumb? Can I not shoot them? I just smell
Lee,
dead.
Shoot this fucker!
I missed. Ow.
Thanks.
Game correct.
Kid.
Whoa! I'm glad I missed them. Oh my god, I love you.
What the fuck is going on?
They're coming.
Oh shit.
That ought to hold them.
Sir, but now how do we get out?
Through the armory.
Pray.
We can just get this damn door open. Come on, damn you!
Don't come.
This is
my fault. I love that word.
What the hell's he babbling about?
Ben, we talked about this.
No, wait. I want to know what he meant. What do you mean this is all your fault?
Kenny, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry,
man. No, Ben.
This ain't the best time. Whatever you did, save
don't
it
don't have
later.
Time.
Ben, we don't have time for this now.
I'm sorry, Lee. I can't do this anymore. He's got
no,
a right to
come
know.
Come on, Ben.
What?
No.
It's been me all along, putting all of us in danger. Katja and Duck, it was all me. It was all me.
What? Ben, why would you tell him that?
What are you saying? It was me who made the deal with the bandits at the motor inn, slipping them supplies. I thought maybe I could keep them off our backs. When it got discovered, that's when they attacked. And that's when Duck...
Why did you have to add that part at the end? Dude, you're not the reason Duck died. Calm down.
Enough! Calm down, man!
You little pissant! You're fucking dead, you hear me? Dead! My wife and child, you gotta both fucking kill!
Kenny, I said calm the fuck down!
Please.
Nice group you got here.
Simmer.
Not the time, Molly.
Yeah, Molly.
If this asshole thinks he's getting on my boat after what he did, he's out of his motherfucking mind!
You know Ben didn't mean any harm. He was just trying to help.
And I'm supposed to give a crap about his good intentions?
Yes.
The boat's not big enough for all of us. Somebody's gotta get left behind. Might as well be this piece of shit right here.
Well, I vote we leave him.
What?
I'm sorry, Ben. I know you mean well. But all I want to do is get back to Omid. And you put that at risk.
Wait, don't I get a vote?
Yes. Of course you do.
Of course you do.
I said that and I didn't even
Ben's
see the options.
Nice. He's my friend. We don't leave friends behind. That's my vote.
On second thought, I think I'm gonna abstain. Lee?
I've seen enough of Crawford to know that becoming like them is the beginning of the end. I vote Ben stays with us.
Yay!
What about the rest of us? Don't we get a say?
No! Whoa!
Now can we go?
Damn right! Vernon, come on!
You're being a little insensitive right now. To his close friend and cancer survivor just died.
So much for the armory. What's left of it?
A few rounds. That's it.
You didn't close that door behind us?
I couldn't. The lock was busted.
Great. Just fucking great. Come!
Don't yell.
There's gotta be a way out down here.
Respect me. Oh, hi. Greetings, friends.
It's not gonna hold. Back upstairs!
Okay.
Lee,
whoa.
Look.
Shotgun. I'm gonna be so badass. Oh, hi. You're dicks. Oh, S. I'm a good shot. Shouldn't have hit. I'm so good. Oh my. Am I dead? Damn it. I clicked out. I'm a freaking idiot. Shoot you. Shoot you. Free. Free me. Free me. Concentrating so hard right now. Thank you. Oh my. Thank you, whoever that is. Woo! Krista can shoot. Oh, I have two weapons now. I prefer melee because you never run out of ammo. It doesn't need ammo. I don't like how some of this stuff is timed. It stresses me out quite a lot. Well, shit. No, not my hatchet! My hatchet!
Come on!
Did you really lose the shotgun too?
Clem! It's alright, Clem. I'm fine.
Of course I am. I'm the main character.
This leads to the roof. We might be able to find a way down from there.
You didn't come into town from the railroad, did you?
Yeah.
Why? Never mind. I can see the sewer where we came in from here. I think we can do this.
Well, what are we waiting for? Go, go!
Let's do this. Wait a minute.
Yeah, come on, let's go!
Oh my god. That's disgusting. No, Ben! No, Ben! Come on, man!
I've got you! Climb up!
Come on!
You can do it! There's no time! You have to go! Now!
Dude!
Turn around, Ben! Come on!
Let go, damn it! Get Clem and the others out of here!
Lee!
No. No, Ken. I can't side with you on this. No. No. No more death. Of course.
Go, go, go!
Because it's not your fault. You're not dead weight. You're kind of the one to reason. You're very
Krista,
analytical and smart.
Everything okay?
You might not be good physically, but you're a very good strategist. Is he dead?
Hold on. Is he dead? Krista, don't! Stay back!
I never should have left you. I'm so sorry.
Krista, get away from him.
Oh, oh my God. Oh, thank the Lord, hey. Jesus.
Back already?
Oh, Mead, you dick.
We got you medicine.
Good. Feel like I could use some.
Thank God.
You okay, kid? You look worse than I do.
We almost didn't make it out of there because of this asshole. Should have left it behind when we had the chance.
Shut up, Kenny.
Guys, what the hell happened out there?
Let someone else tell you. I got work to do.
Dick.
Okay, with a little luck, you should start feeling better pretty soon. Oh. I'll stay here for a few more hours to check on him. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks, Doc.
Yes, thank you so much.
Maybe now's a good time for you and me to have a little talk in private.
Oh, goodness. Yeah.
Listen, man. About what happened to Bree.
Don't beat yourself up over it. There was nothing you could have done. You want to know the worst part?
What?
I don't feel much. I mean, I don't feel enough. Shouldn't I be broken up over what happened to her? That's how I was when I lost my daughter. When I lost my friends in those first few weeks. But now, it's like I just take something like this in stride. Like this is what our world is now. We'd better just get used to it.
It's kind of a natural reaction.
What did you want to talk to me about?
I know you care about Clementine.
Of course.
Anyone can see that. And I know you want what's best for her. But this plan of yours, putting everyone on a boat with no destination, do you really think that's her best chance of finding somewhere where she can be safe? Because I don't. So I want to make you an offer.
What kind of an offer?
I'll take her off your hands.
No.
Take her back with me, to my people. We're well supplied, well hidden, and a lot of us have had kids of our own. And now Crawford's fallen, we got nothing left to fear from them. She'll be safe with us. Safer than she will be if she stays with you, I promise you. That's what you want for her, isn't it? To be safe?
You're coming at me with a lot here, Vernon. I need to think it over.
Of course, take your time. But I want you to think about some things.
I don't want to give Clementine...
You're a good man, Lee. You've been protecting these people as best you can so far. And they look up to you. Rightly so. But it's different with a child. You might have brought her this far, but sooner or later, she might ask you for more than you can give her. I'm sorry if that's hard to hear, but it's the truth.
Yeah.
I appreciate it, Vernon. Let me think about it, okay?
You do that.
Just can't, though. Her and I... We're a team. I've become like a father figure to her. And that's something... That it's too precious to give up. Are you okay?
Hey, going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm about to head out. I just wanted to say thanks for everything. It's been fun.
You bet it has. That's it?
So that's it? After all we've been through, you're just gonna leave?
Yeah.
Man.
I figured you don't owe me anything. I got what I wanted in Crawford, and I never did like the water.
Where will you go?
I don't know. I'll figure it out when I get there.
What do you want me to tell the others?
Tell them whatever you want. I'm not real big on goodbyes. Tell Clementine she's going to be okay. You've got a good one there. She reminds me of me.
Strong-willed. Good-spirited. That makes me happy. It makes me proud. I helped with that. Hey, Clem.
Hey, sweet pea.
Kenny's working on the boat.
Yeah.
I know.
What are we going to do after he fixes it? Where will we go?
What do you want to do? I'm curious. Someplace else.
Someplace else. Someplace better. Clem, honey, what's wrong?
Is Ben going to be okay? He doesn't seem the same since he got back.
Yeah. He feels guilty.
Ben's a good kid. I think he's just feeling guilty about some of the decisions he's made. He's gotten a feeling like he's a burden on the rest of us.
Before we leave tomorrow,
shitty feeling.
Will we have time to look for my parents?
I want to look for...
I'd like to, Clem, but I don't think we'll have time. We really shouldn't stay here any longer. It's not safe.
I want to look for her parents, though. Dude. Sorry. Hug me. Oh, no. I'm gonna... My heart is breaking. Right in two. The notifications are making it worse. Dicks. It's not okay. Stomach is growling like crazy.
Clementine?
Clem? Hello?
Clementine?
I guess she's okay now. Maybe she's hanging out with Kenny and all them, I guess. I can apologize to her. Because I want to look for her parents. I really do. Chances are they're not alive, but I want to... At least she needs
Clementine?
To know what happened to him.
Clementine!
Where is she?
God.
No. No, 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 no. Did she freaking get kidnapped? Or did she run away? Oh, no. Clem? No. No, 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 no. Oh my God. No. Why, Clem, why? Oh my God! Good Lord! Oh my God. Freaking jump scares up the ass. No! There's blood on her hat. No!
No. No.
No.
No. No. Fuck.
Please?
No!
You out here?
No, 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 no! Why? Why?
Are you crazy? What are you doing out here? It ain't
I'm
safe.
Not hiding that.
Lee, where's Clementine? She's not in her room.
Guys.
Vernon ain't in the house either.
Help me.
What the hell is going on?
Whose blood is that?
It's mine.
Oh my God.
No way. No. No fucking way.
There's no time to worry about me. Clementine's gone.
There's no chance she just wandered off on her own? Then who the hell took her?
I don't know. Last night, Vernon came to me and offered to take her with him. Said she'd be better off.
Son of a bitch. I knew we couldn't trust that fucker.
Wherever she is, I have to find her.
Okay. What do you need from us?
I need help.
Clem may not have much time. We have a better chance of finding her if we all go together. Who's with me?
Please.
We're all responsible for Clementine. And in your condition, you may not make it to her in time. She needs our help.
Yeah.
All of our help.
Damn right. We can't let you do this alone.
So that's settled then. We'll look for Clementine together.
Thank you.
Hell yeah. What are we waiting for?
Thanks, you guys. I appreciate it.
I really do. Kenny, are you coming? Kenny.
Lee, man. You know I care about Clementine.
Dude!
And I am a Christian man.
Don't break up with myself. Me.
If this was me asking you for help, asking are you to put your
me?
Life on the line, would you be there for me? Because there have been plenty of times when you ain't been.
I've been there for you. Clementine's my family. I need you.
Hey, man, I'm begging you here. I can't do this alone. I need your help, please.
Lee, I know you had my back when we first teamed up. You really looked out for me.
Really?
Ever since then, you've been looking out for yourself more often than your friends.
What?
I'm sorry, but you're on your own on this
one. You've got to be kidding me.
What about you, Ben?
I don't know. Whatever you think is best.
Clementine stood up for you.
Clementine's one of the few good things left in this world.
Yeah.
She stood up for you and Crawford when Kenny wanted you gone. Don't you think you owe it to her to stand up for her now?
You're right. I owe her. I swear, before this is all over, I'm gonna show you I can do something right. I'll prove it to you. You'll see.
Thanks, Ben.
Okay, guys.
Kenny, go fuck yourself.
Let's head out.
I'll get the boat out onto the river.
You're an ass.
Or I can wait there until you get back. Or at least until nightfall.
Why are you such a dick?
Even Ben.
Yeah. We'll figure out what to do about that when the time comes.
Why won't you come with me? I love you, Kenny. Even though I hate you. Damn it. This
come
is
on,
so
guys,
conflicting.
Let's go.
Bye, Kenny. Ass. I should have chose Clementine as my family option. Because, like, with Ben, he was more responsive to, like, me talking about Clem, and... Damn it. I don't have time. This is a very long episode, I'm telling you right now. Hope it's over soon, so my technology doesn't die. Oh. Well, they're gone.
Where the hell are they?
Hello?
Looks like they got out of here in a hurry.
Damn. Really?
Vernon, get out here! There doesn't have to be any trouble here. All I want is the girl. Give her back and nobody needs to get hurt.
Why? Come on. Keep it together, man. Stop notifying me, damn it. I'm just so over all these notifications. Oh my god. I'm gonna see if I can sign this yourself for the next episode. Clem?
Are you alright? Where are you? Vernon, you son of a bitch!
Cody.
Wait. What? Who is this?
Who is this?
It's not Vernon, if that's what you're thinking. And you should really watch your tone.
You...
Clementine's fine. But if I were you, I'd choose my next words very carefully.
Don't hurt her. Really? Damn you, game. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, wow, I'm in the majority in all of these. I killed the boy in the attic. I was rational and honest with Vernon. I brought Clementine to Crawford, obviously. I saved Ben. And I revealed my bite. Because I'm an idiot sometimes. Oh, this is cool. Okay. I could have gone alone? Oh, that's awful. I could have gone with just Ben. That's the least chosen option. I'm on the lower side of the majority, but why would Christo and Omid not go with me? That's interesting. 14% of people. I do really wish Kenny went with me, but, you know, just because I didn't agree with all of his choices, and, you know, even though I killed the son for him and killed the boy in the attic for him and was there for him when Duck was bitten and when we thought he was bitten, but, that's okay. Because, of course, you know, that doesn't matter. Let me click. And that's the game. I'm going to go continue to be butthurt about Kenny. And go to sleep. It's almost 1 a.m. Thank you for joining me on this journey again. And I'll see you on episode 5, No Time Left. And we've just finished episode 4 of On Demand Corner. So, episode 5, last episode, next. On The Walking Dead. Bye. Oh. That was a dumb outro.